getting to Dad Time Express.
Express? What do you mean by express?
It's like the new social media exclusive Dad Time episode that we're putting out during quarantine because, you know, it's like the in-between seasons. Like, you know how, like, Trevor Noah has, like, the in-between the scenes where he just, like, talks to people and stuff? Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's like Dad Time Express. Dad Time Express is the in-between seasons. So we just have, like, as we're, like, recording stuff. So we've been recording things and episodes, but the season's not fully recorded yet, so we haven't released it all. But while we're waiting, we're doing these little Dad Time Express episodes. So, you know, you guys hear from us, and it's just, like, it's not really scripted. We're just chilling. Not that the other podcasts were scripted.
Wait, was it? No. But yeah, so Chat Time
Express. I don't know. Was it?
So Chat Time Express is going to be a social media exclusive solely on Facebook and Instagram for the time being. And it's just a way for us to talk to everyone and just pretty much just express what we think since quarantine happened. Because of quarantine, you know, a lot of things has changed in our lives. And even when it comes to taking the time to record has been a lot harder with, you know, with everything and just all these, like, different topics coming up in the world. So, you know, instead of being radio silent, we just wanted to have these little bitty, you know, 15-20 minute episodes to just chill.
Yeah, you know, we make sure you guys know we're not dead. Kind of the main reason, right? I think that you know, like, it's also kind of cool because when you're like just by yourself for so long, you start to, like, you know, start to, like, brainstorm a lot of stuff. So
yeah,
we've been brainstorming a lot of things and thinking about all the guests that we want to have on. But you know what? This is podcast as much as it is for us. It's for you guys. And so we wanted to hear from you to see, really, you know, who do you guys want to see on the podcast and stuff?
Yeah, like, we've been reaching out to very, very, like, famous celebrities that we want to talk about their stories, right? That's what Chat Time is like. That's what Chat Time is there for, right? We want to interview and share these Asian Canadians and Asian Americans' story, and just have everyone be able to relate in some sort of way.
I mean, we're also reaching out to very not famous people as well, because I feel like everyone's got, like, an interesting story,
right?
So, you know, like, yeah, sure. Who would you like to see on the podcast?
Me, you know, like, as a designer, as, like, a creative, I would want someone, like, who, I want someone who's, like, creative, come on the show, talk about their story, you know, so at least I can get some sort of inspiration, because with, again, with everything going on, I'm having a creative block, so it'll be nice to just have, like, a fresh open eyes. So someone, like Sam Shuey, I saw him, he was part of, another conference I went to. And I'm like, hey, what would happen if I sat down and talked with him and be like, how is he still able to make music while quarantined and all that, right? Because it takes a lot of work to make music.
I mean, did you, though? Did you sit down next to Sam Sui?
No, I want to.
Yeah, but, no, but, like, you saw him at a conference, right?
And no.
Like, did you, like, sit down next to him?
No, of course not. This is a
missed opportunities.
It was a virtual conference. There's no way I can sit next to him. I can move my.
Was it on Zoom?
It was on Zoom.
Request a breakout room with Sam. So he'd be like, excuse me, organizer, I would just like a breakout room, please.
Right.
when you actually said someone who was a creative like that, I was like, Ken Jeong.
Oh, he would be a very funny character to come on. Like, I can see the vibe happening between you and him.
I think honestly, he's just such a genuine person, and it's cool because he's had that both sides of the thing. He's got that nice fame and like, you know, kind of like the glamorous life. And then he was also just like a doctor where he's like, yeah, this is how life works. I understand. So like, it's kind of cool. He would kind of be like that one character that, or like the one guest I'd love to have on one of those, like, where do I go with my life episodes?
Yeah.
You know, like, my mom wants me to be a doctor, but I would love comedy or something like that. And then he could literally speak to both sides of that. Like, how crazy would that be?
I remember you showed me like even a Comedy Central like special show. It was like from Jimmy O. Yang too. Like when I heard his stuff, like they were pretty funny. We were all dying on the couch. Like that would be someone who would be really interesting to bring in, right?
Yeah, like, I can see that. Bernard Tai. No, that like his character in Crazy Rich Asian, Bernard Tai.
Oh yeah, like even like Crazy Rich Asian, like there was so many characters, so many cast members on there, and like it blew up because it was like what, like the first Asian American casted film.
Yeah, yeah, and I think. Honestly, probably it's been something that's building up for a really long time, but it's after that that we have like something now Raya, the first Southeast Asian Disney princess that's voiced by a Southeast Asian person.
Yeah, and who happens to be Vietnamese.
Yeah, so that's pretty cool.
So like it'll be cool to like have their experience. I was like, okay, like. How does it feel like being voiced, like being like a Disney princess, like voiced as a Disney princess?
We're getting ideas here.
Right. So like those are the kind of people. Like even there are people who are like more commonly, not like celebrities, I guess, or like famous Hollywood people, but maybe like even those that you see on social media a lot. So like someone like I see on social media a lot and I get a lot of inspiration from is Chris Doe.
Stephen Ngo. Sorry, go ahead. I'm just jumping screw.
Is Chris Doe. He's actually a really popular designer who posts a lot of his works on Instagram. And I see it and I just I enjoy like all of his discussions, all his like workshops. And like he's done so much in the design world and I just want to like have that time to sit down and be like, okay, what can make me a better designer, like a more skilled designer. Right.
Mm-hmm. That's not a bad idea.
Yeah. Yeah. Or like, I remember when we had the episode with Trit and then how he spoke about his life coming to the United States. And how that related so much to our parents coming into North America. So,
that's true.
And, like, you know, with that mindset, you know that mindset, like you said, was like doctor, lawyer, and all that. But there's so many people who are out there and they're not any of those things. Like, I wonder how they're like.
That is okay.
That is
perfectly fine. 100%
okay. And I want to know how they got through it. Cause look at them now. Actually,
you know who we should bring on if like that's what we're talking about. Ooh. Remember that one guy on like Subtle Asian Traits was posted. He was like, it was like a Marine and then a surgeon and then an astronaut.
No.
There's this one guy that they were posting on Subtle Asian Traits, and like it's like, oh, it's the guy everyone's Asian mom compares you to, and he's like, yeah, I was like a Marine. SEAL team or something like that.
I think I know.
And then like, he was like a cardiac surgeon, and then now it's like that. And then NASA just picked him up to be an astronaut. And you're like, how could I ever be this person? Like, mom, still comparing me to this guy.
Actually, there was a meme on Facebook where, and it actually related to me because it was a graphic design meme. And then there was like a son and father was on an airplane. And the father's like, why don't you get a real job? Like, not this whole graphic designer stuff, but like an actual job. And then, some other passenger started getting like a cardiac arrest or started to like.
Oh, is this that one where it's like, oh, you should ask him if he wants to save it as PDF?
Exactly. Yeah. Like, it's like, see, like, a doctor can save him, but you can't use your AI files or PSD Photoshop files to save him. It's and it's like, there are people, like, there are parents who actually think that way.
I mean, I don't think that way, but in that situation, I would much prefer to have a doctor than a graphic designer. Like, I'm not lying. Like, yeah, if someone is having cardiac arrest, like, it's like, I can save files as PSD. It's like, cool, bro. I did ask that.
But no, like, I like, yeah, but I mean, to each their own in terms of like what they want to be. And like nowadays with the next generation, where I'm seeing that we're like slowly going away from that doctor, lawyer job mentality. And a lot of people are trying to pursue things that they want to pursue.
I think that's awesome, because we have such a big drive, and obviously there's more than three types of jobs. But I think one of the things, and I know this because I went through this when I was younger too. I mean, I'm going through that now because I am young. Nailed that. But, you know, if, you know, like, I think as I'm getting older, I'm starting to realize now that, like, our parents, they just want us to have jobs. So as long as you can, like, let them know that your job has some sort of stability or it has some sort of potential there, then it's like, you know, they'll be okay with it. But I feel like a lot of, like, young people that jump into the artistic side, they do so without, like, an understanding of how to make their thing practical. So, like, if you're like, oh, yeah, I'm just going to be an artist, then it's just like, okay, that's great. I support you to be an artist, but how are you going to make money from that? Like, if you have, like, a clear plan, it's like, okay, so I've researched my market. Like, when I paint flowers, I know that the standard flower painting goes for this much on the market. I know that there's these people that buy it. I know that I've built a connection with, you know, this gallery or this bank, and they buy photographs and, like, art pieces like this to display in their branches or something like that. And if you have that understanding, then, like, that's great. That's fantastic. That's how you should approach an artistic job or vocation like that. But, like, if you're just like, I want to do art because I am so passionate about it, and you're like, okay, that's great, but how is it going to work? Then you're like, I don't know. I'm just an artist, bruh. I'm just doing art because I love it. Then you're like, okay, bro, then you really shouldn't do art. Not at least until you have a strong understanding of how your art business works.
Right.
You know?
I mean, that was me at one point. Like, I knew I wanted to go into the creative industry the moment that I started, you know, doing stuff in high school. And then the more I helped out in high school working in media, working in, like, yearbook and all that, it was like, this is exactly what I want to do. And it took me, like, many full-time jobs to understand how to run a business, because I don't work for, like, a large corporate company where I don't understand, where it's hard for me to understand other people's jobs. No, this was an small office with the boss, a sales rep, and me. Three people. That's all it took. And, you know, I guess he's been working on, my boss at the time was working on it, and he would put us, like, myself and the sales rep would have a lot of experience doing more than just our job positions, because there's only so much of us that can that he can handle with in terms of work.
I think, like, if you're going to be a creative, I think you need to have the ability to pair that with, like, other skills too.
Exactly.
So, like, if you're a creative, you shouldn't require someone to be a salesperson. It's like, oh yeah, I'm going to be a creative and I'm going to jump into, like, a media firm or, like, a graphic design firm. You should have the ability to just do that on your own, because sometimes it's not easy to jump into a graphic design firm. So sometimes, like, you have to be your own salesperson. You have to be your own, like, bookkeeper. You have to be your own accounts manager,
yep,
or client service rep or something like that. Yep. And so I think that as I get older, I am understanding that I think that's what our parents, like, are saying, is, like, we should have these skills as well. And if you want to pursue that, you know, go right the fuck ahead. But, like, there's you need to be well-rounded so that you can use your passion effectively. And, you know, when you're doing art and you're being creative, you want people to see your stuff. And so if you're effective at showcasing all your art, then, you know, it's power to you. You get to show people what you're passionate about.
Yeah. And I mean, I guess they want us to have, like, all these, you know, high paying jobs so that we can return the favor, and give back to our parents what they gave us, and, like, everything that they went through. Like, is that kind of mentality? Do you have that kind of mentality at, like, to a certain point?
I don't think my parents, I mean, I'm just speaking for myself,
right?
But I don't think my parents have that mentality. They just they want to make sure that, like, their grandkids are not going to have to, I guess, deal with the same things that maybe I dealt with, because, you know, they were new immigrants,
right,
and stuff. And so they're just like, oh, hey, like, you should work in a way so that your kids have a better childhood than you did.
Right.
And I think that's kind of their main worry, is, like, it's like, oh no, if you don't have money, and then if you can prove to them that whatever you are doing is lucrative, then, like, you know, I think you essentially quash all of the concerns they have. Like parents, most parents are, like, pretty old school, so they don't know about a lot of the new industries that are super up and coming. So, like, I had a friend who was a environmental consultant, and they were like, is that a job? And I'm like, I think so. I mean, it makes a crap ton of money. And they're like, well, what does he do? It's like, well, he consults with companies and lets them know what is the best way for them to become green and become sustainable. And they're like, that's not a job. That's just fancy words. And I'm like, the guy makes, like, 250K a year. And they're like, oh, so that is a job. Okay.
See, when they hear a lot of money, then they're like, yeah, that's a job.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, like, no, I mean, that's just, like, maybe I had that thought because my parents have done so much for me that I'm like, hey, I want to push so hard into making enough so that I can give back to my parents, make sure that they live, like, you know, they have a good retirement, or, you know, they don't have to worry about paying for anything. I can take care of myself and stuff like that. So I guess it's a little bit of both. It's a little bit of, we want to take care of our parents the same way they took care of us when we were kids and they had nothing. But at the same time, just like you said, they also might want us to be able to support our own families when we have them, and not have to, you know, go in debt or having to work harder for, like, in our lives.
Right? No, I agree. I mean, I think it's a difference between what they want and what we want.
Right.
Because obviously we want to take care of them too.
Right.
But, like, for them, they're just like, ah, we don't care. Just make sure that, you know, you're not knocking on my door and be like, I need to pay my mortgage and I can't, or something like that. So.
Exactly.
Oh, man.
I know so many people out there who are like, yeah, I'm getting paid this week, but I need to save it for paying the bills. I need to save it for food.
There you go.
And, you know.
Yeah. And that's nothing wrong with that either.
Yeah.
It's just everyone has different circumstances. But I think obviously your parents don't want that for you. And that's it. And like, for them, they're like, they came over and they were just like, okay, I don't like this job, but for me, it's a necessity. So, like, passion about your job is not something that was super big for them. It's something big for us because, you know, we have the luxury of doing something that we like.
Right.
They had, you know, multiple barriers and hurdles and stuff. And so they didn't have the luxury of being like, oh, I'll do this because I like it. They're like, oh, if doing this nets me this amount of money, that means that I can take care of my kids. and stuff, or I can take care of my family, or I can take care of like my family back in old country.
Right.
So like, you know, for them, they didn't have that luxury, but for us, we do. And so what we have to do is I think we just have to take that into account when they're like, you must only be doctor, you must only be dentist or pharmacist or something of that sort.
I love how you go with a Russian accent.
My parents are Russian. I'm not sure if you know that.
How long have I known you? And I thought you were like Southeast Asian, not Russian.
Apparently, I'm just Russian, you know. До свидания.
Okay.
Меня зовут Калвин. Хорошо. But yeah, no, I think it's kind of weird because we're talking about having like people on the show to talk about this, and then we just like jumped into this. We're like, damn it, we've ruined this hot topic now.
Well, no, because it still goes back to the people that we want to talk to, because it's not like mm-hmm. you and I that only go through this. Like all of our, like any Asian North American individual will be dealing with this one way or another. Might be easier for them, might be harder on them, might be a lot of stress on them. Like, we don't know. And that's what I want to know. I want to speak to someone and try to relate with them. And that's why we want to have all these different individuals, whether they're in a creative field or not. And if they're not, and they're just, you know, if they're not in a creative field, then they should still be in, like, I don't know, someone that we know who fits the criteria in the finance world or in the business world, you know, as like founders or whatever, right?
Or, you know, be like really crazy is if like we got someone to talk about the fact that like their parents are very artsy people. Right. Maybe they came over and they were artists back in old country. And they're like, I was artist. You will be artist too. And he's like, no, dad, I want to be a doctor. And he's like, oh, I'm so disappointed in you. And you're like, he's like, oh, my God. Like, it's like the reverse. But like, I guess it must happen somewhere.
I know, like, I've heard people talk about, oh, yeah, my mom used to be like a singer in the opera, my dad used to be this, so, and then I want to also continue that music in the family kind of thing, or even like with instruments too. Like it's like that sort of art, or even like visual arts too. Like if let's say they're a parental figure drew something, but then now they save that drawing and now they or painting. And now they want to keep that passion growing strong. So it really depends on the arts or in what kind of creative it is. But everyone goes through some sort of, you know, some sort of back and forth with their parents.
This is to say that Kelly Marie Tran, we'd love to have you on the show. So if you see this, that would be great.
Yeah, our social links are like down below. At Tech Time Podcast, Facebook, Instagram.
Imagine if we had a Disney princess on this, a Disney princess that was also in Star Wars.
I know, like that'd be cool. Like,
my God,
I know you would have a lot of questions.
I would just be like, what is John Boyega like in real life? Like, tell me about John Boyega.
Like, don't talk about yourself. Like, no. We want to hear.
I want to hear about her, but I'm also just like the white stormtrooper that wields a lightsaber. How cool is that?
I don't watch too much Star Wars to know.
Oh my God, you need to start watching more Star Wars, my friend. You need to watch more Star Wars.
Well, yeah, like. So for everyone else out there, who would you want us to talk to? Who do you want to hear their life story and how they grew up to be who they are today? I mean, feel free to leave us a comment, send us a message, and, you know, who knows, we might feature your answers in a future episode. So here's that sneak peek of Chat Time Express. We're not going anywhere. We're still prepping season 2. We want to do more. We want to make it more exciting, and we can't do it without your feedback and your suggestions. If you want to know more about what we've done in the past, season one is already on every social media, every podcast platform out there. If you want to view it on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, anywhere you can find podcasts, we're there. Just search us up, Chat Time Podcast, TRATIME.
It's funny because I didn't have to tell you to give them a spiel. You just did it.
I just did
like
it.
We're that level of efficient now. Yeah. I'm just like, I'm a little silent, and the Ash is like, it's spiel time.
It's Chat Time season two. It's 2.0.
We are bringing the electricity, the energy for like Chat Time, like podcast season two. Like we're getting all these great guests. Things are going to be more ridiculous.
We're going to be having a launch party at one point.
Yasher may even shave his beard and donate it to me so that I have a beard.
I really want one. We'll talk about it. I'll see what I can do.
Dude, you promised, okay? You promised backstage. You said I could have your beard.
Oh, right. I did write a note about it. Okay, fine. Okay, we'll talk about it later. But, there's one more thing I want. Oh, and like we're changing things up a bit. Like now with this, now we have video as well. Season one had no video, right? We did it a full audio podcast, but we want to take it one step further. We want you to see us. We want you to like watch us discuss it outside of just being able to listen. So.
Yasher doesn't just do his hair for no reason, you know. Like it's like he'll do his hair and then we'll sit there in front of the mic and he's like, no one sees my hair. I put so much work into it.
Like I want to show my videos so people can like the beard. Like that's my number one feature of me.
And I showcase my lack of beard.
But you do have nice hair, okay?
Yeah, that's covered. Look at the coverage. Oh my god. Ah.
Like you don't know how much I'm like, I want like that kind of straight hair so I can dye it.
I'll trade you for your beard, man. I'll trade you for your beard.
I'm down. Like I have curly hair. It's really hard to want to dye my hair, but I know that if I dye my hair, my parents are going to kill me.
Don't you like wear a hat like 90% of the time?
I only wear it when I feel lazy to just like cut my hair.
Just wear your hair. Just wear your hat.
Wear my hair.
And then whatever your parents are around, just put the hat on and then you're good.
Yeah, that's true. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Why are you wearing your hat a lot in your house now?
I just love it. It's a great hat. Makes me feel good about myself, so like totally I'm gonna do this. Chat Time Podcast, sorry, Chat Time Express episode 1.
Yeah.